Hi everyone, I'm back here again with another tutorial, and this time this is again one of my requested looks. I think I was wearing this look in one of my updated or message videos. I don't really remember, but I'm going to put that link in this video so that you can see which look I'm talking about. So I'll just show you the look a little closer. So this is the look that we're going to do. It's all about using three eyeshadow colors, that is yellow, orange and pink. And the colors that I'll be using is my palette called the Neon Eyes. And we'll be using these three colors, that yellow, orange and that pink. So before I start, I'm just going to tell you what I've already done. I have just primed my eyes using a normal Prime and Fix primer from Rimmel, and on top of that I've applied a white eyeshadow pencil, just so that, because we're using very light colors, like orange is very light in this one, in this palette, and the yellow is also very light, and I really want the colors to show up. So that is how I've applied that white color or white pencil as a base. So let's get started with
the first color that I'll be using is this yellow here, and I'm just using my fingers to apply this color, since yellow is a very very light color and it's very difficult to get the right color payoff, and probably will have to apply a lot of layers of it. So all I'm just doing is I'm applying the yellow color to the 2/3 of my eye, gently using the patting motion, and then kind of smudging it so that it gets there and it sticks to the eyeshadow pencil or the base that I've used. So as you can see, I'm just applying layers and layers of this color because I want this yellow to show. So you apply it till the time you're satisfied that yes, the color is showing off well. And you also apply this yellow to the innermost corner of your eye. So just like that. Using my finger, I'm taking the orange color that I'm already showed you, and I'm gonna apply it to the rest of my eye using the same patting and smudging motion. And I'm gonna just tell you how we blend these two colors using our fingers. Fingers are the best tool, and it's the easiest tool to use to apply eyeshadow and blend two eyeshadow colors. And as we did similarly, what we did to the yellow, we're gonna do to the orange, because it's again a very light neon orange. So once we come to the point of contact where the two colors meet, all we do is we kind of use padding motions and go in very lightly. So you want to leave just kind of 1/3 of your eye with yellow, and want to apply the orange to the rest. So wherever there's a contact between yellow and orange, where the two colors meet, you'll see that the orange is slightly lighter to the rest of the part where there's just orange. This look is really, really simple and very fun to do. So, again, you have to keep applying till the time you think that the color payoff is what you want. So, as I've done it, you can see. Next, I'm going to take a round brush like this. Mine is from e.l.f. Dip it into the pink. The pink is really nice and dark. So, all we need to do is now, just onto the outer corner and this crease, you apply the pink. Just like so. And kind of take it slightly above the crease. The best way to blend pink into the orange is to just use circular motions, because you don't want to really take the color too far in. You really want it to be just in the outer section and the crease. The next, I'm just using a normal bronzer. Mine is from Rimmel. Same round brush. I'm just going in to the innermost part of my eye, that is here. Blending that brown into the pink. Just so that it kind of softens it a bit. Doesn't make it look too harsh. Going back with the round brush into the yellow, I'm just kind of darkening the yellow a bit. Because these are all matte colors, and when you apply matte colors, they just tend to run down when you're applying too many colors. And then back to my orange with the round brush, kind of darken the orange a bit. As you can see, I'm just using padding motions. I'm going to now take this small brush, take a little bit of yellow, and apply it to the lower lash line. Just the inner one third. And then take the orange, apply it to the outer part of my eye, the rest two thirds. This just kind of opens up the eye a lot. So we're almost done here. Now, what I'm going to do is, I'm going to take a little bit of this green here with this brush. Just very little. And just add this green here. Just over that brown. Just kind of tiny little bit. For my highlighter color, I'm using a very light, kind of a goldy highlight. This one here, with my brush, normal eyeshadow brush. And the reason why I'm using this light golden highlight is because the colors on my lid are so vibrant and bright that I don't want any more to be added on. So I'm just using kind of a light, shimmery highlight. And I'm blending the highlighter over the pink just to kind of soften the edges a bit. Just like so. So, our look is almost complete. All I need to do is go back, apply some dark kohl and eyeliner, and I'll show you once the look is completed. For my eyeliner, I'm going to apply a very thick line, as you can see in this, with a very short wing, and keep my kohl a bit thicker and darker. So I'll just complete the look
and
get back to you.
So guys, this is the complete look, and all I've done is I've applied a very thick eyeliner, as you can see, with a very, very short wing. And for my eyeliner, I use the Extreme 24-Hour Felt Tip Eyeliner from Collection 2000. And I've applied a very nice thick layer of mascara, and for my mascara I've used the Maybelline's Pulse Perfection Mascara, the one with the vibrating wand. And just to keep the look really simple and, you know, kind of not too harsh, I've applied a very nude color lip gloss and just my basic plum blusher. So I really hope you enjoyed this look and this tutorial. I'll see you again with more tutorials very soon. And until then, bye-bye and take care.